And speaking of which,
off to
Garden Terror. Did you know? Yesterday I was doing the Learn to Play show, and I had two Garden Terror games. So I was thinking, how great would it be to finish out with a pro Garden Terror game? They haven't played in a pro in a Heroes Global Championship game.
Right.
Garden Terror hasn't been picked in 3 months. What do we
want
to ban, by the way?
That's gotta say something. We're first pick. Wait, let's find out if he plays Kerrigan. Otherwise. All right, then Garden of Terror. We would need a split push or Zag or Zul, I think.
These guys seem to want to get rid of KT.
Let the other team do it.
That's true.
If we get Kerrigan.
And we have the false dad, so.
Yeah,
we
no,
want to knock out the Zag.
Ban it, yeah, let's get Zag out of there. I think that's right. She's very difficult to deal with. So let's just take that off the table.
Yeah, certainly difficult to deal with. I think Zul has a more powerful presence, but he's more easily screwed up. I see a lot of bad Zuls. I don't see a lot of awful Zagaras.
All right, support over here. I assume you want to play Diablo.
Yeah, since we're not in voice comms together, the Tyrael is really cute, but I go protection and death, so I really need to make sure my Thrall and my Kerrigan stay under my death umbrella.
Wait a second. Remember, we talked about this last week.
I agree. When we had that conversation, we talked about how, you know, getting control of both the tank and the support can be rather rough, but we got the Kerrigan. Oh, wait. Sleepy wants to do the Lili now? This guy's a card. Nice.
What? Z.
Ooh.
Oh, wow. I'm going blind here. All right. Maybe I shouldn't have asked. Now we got Lili.
That's all right.
All right. So we need a lane push. We talked about it at the beginning of the show.
Yeah. So you want to take on that role? I mean, actually, the Lili has, if observant, has some really good opportunities with the Wind Fury and the Tychus to negate a lot of damage for us. I don't really want to do Diablo into Tychus since he's all health based.
Mm-hmm.
So that starts to put me back on the Tyrael.
We've got Kerrigan on the front line. Do we want a specialist? Yeah, we need a specialist here. You don't want a Gazlo, do you?
No, that's not really lane clear.
Yeah.
It's kind of slow. Right. It takes build up.
I don't know.
I like getting rid of the orc bras too. I mean, if you want a tank, I can do the Lost Vikings.
I don't know about this team. I don't like the way they're chatting. They seem like goofballs. I want us to have a presence in the fights, I think.
Well, Z is saying the enemy of the orc is bad, so that's something in our favor.
It's too much. Do we just go ahead and... Oh, you know what? We've got the Sylvanas. Sylvanas can be pretty strong. Do you like that with Tyrael?
Yeah, that works for me.
Yeah, okay. Let's do that.
Sadly, we don't get to exercise our dual queue powers much, but...
Well, we're last pick. We gotta fill what we can. Well, man, my game is glitching out. Do you have this? Like,
yeah, there's a couple broken characters on my screen.
You're so holy that it's just white hexagon.
Oh, and they're pure black on my screen.
Oh.
But I guess you get a crapshoot one or the other.
That's great. All right, we got Kerrigan. This either means we lose or we win based on whatever happened. We're gonna find out. with the changes to her, right? Is it just a health nerf, mostly? She wasn't touched too much.
Yeah, she got a little bit of a battle momentum decrease, and some of her prime talents, part of the build, were slightly knocked down. But the raw damage, the auto attacks, have been unchanged. So I don't expect that we'll run into, you know... It might be a surprise. That's the scary part. Is this going to be too big a surprise for the Kerrigan, and she ends up accidentally dying?
Yeah, these are just very targeted to that one build, it looks like. The damage reduction at level 1, Sonic Pulse is a little weaker, and Bladed Momentum... Well, I never took that, so don't care. I think it's just the health that's going to be the biggest factor here. If she can be burst easier. All right. Is the shield a new upgrade from the recent changes to Tyrael?
I'm not entirely sure, honestly. It's been such a long time since I played Tyrael, and then it was always quick match, so it was almost exclusively damage Tyrael. Because, well, quick match.
Oh, I should be pinging to cheese Elaine. Although, they've probably seen me here.
I think these guys are still hanging around, but... Yep, here we go.
I got Thrall in the bot lane with me.
Cool, we need to get some people into the top, but I think we'll be okay for a little bit. Lili is panicking hard. That's a shame. If she would have relaxed through that zombie wall, she would have been just fine. But she spent it running. I'm going to head top since no one else is. Oom? What?
I think this guy's a joker.
A prankster?
Yeah, with a name like ZZZZ, he might not have come in to play. And it's reasons like that where I'm like, why am I prepping so hard to play Hero League?
Right, exactly. I'm like, I really can't control other people's play, so why be hard on myself?
It's tilting if you spend a lot of time prepping to have someone come in and just be a goofball.
Mm-hmm.
And you might say, well, I'm going to prep anyways because that's my approach. And you should still do that. But if it tilts you to prep too much... you might want to consider, you know, releasing some of that pressure to perform. But we'll see. It's early. We're not sure yet. How's top going?
Good. I'm going to die here. Oh, no. Get in the ghost. Get in the ghost. Cool. They did it.
Yeah, Lili, for some reason, decided to come with me, even though you're the main fighting force.
Well, he's gonna get. It's looks like it's just Trade Town up top. Finally. Kerrigan does seem a little lacking.
Tell her to wait for your engage. The worst thing, the way to play Kerrigan is to go in first. Get focus.
All right, let's get in on this.
Oh, behind.
Oh, yeah, there's... Huh.
No, more. We're coming.
Looks like Raynor's firing it up, though. And there's an Azebo in the very top. As soon as I'm done tanking this. I mean, this is pretty loud what we're doing here. Okay, he left.
Yeah, I'm gonna clear top lane. Oh, okay, I'm gonna clear two minions of the top lane.
I'm gonna take these guys down bottom.
Okay. Zebo's top, so it should be a 4v4.
And Thrall's in the actual bottom lane. I just need to take a little break here and make sure. Get everyone out.
No, we almost got a full. Oh, there's that one up top. If I just get it.
Yeah, you're right. There's one sitting in the bottom as well, but
We don't need it. I got
that
this
top one. That's awesome. All right, so Lili is heading bot. That's fine. Kerrigan is...
All right, how many do you think are coming up top? I see... I almost called her Gonzalez. I mean, Morales.
Nice.
Racist. All right. All right.
So, looks like we're back. So, we don't have a rider at the moment. Did you want to do that?
Maybe. I might be going down. I got caught in a zombie wall. Zombie wall. All right, I'll take it.
Cool.
Can't decide between barb shot and unstable poison.
I really like you not taking it, of course, because that means we could shut down the buildings for you, but...
Oh, yeah, this is really dumb of me to taking it. Oh, well.
No, it's okay. These guys weren't really on board.
Yeah. I'm good on the terror anyways, so...
Works for me. That's usually what it comes down to as well. And that's something I see a lot in lower leagues, is people saying they don't want to... They want to carry, but then they don't want to ride the beast.
Yeah, this thing is a team fighting machine here. Okay, look at this. She's out, caught out. Get her, Kerrigan.
Oh, body blocks are better. Those got fixed this morning.
Oh, are they? Yeah, that's good, actually.
Let's get over here and shield up the Kerrigan a little bit.
We're gonna get planted. Careful, I'll take 1 second on a plant. Okay. Oh, look at this. Get him.
Nice. She's trying to...
I'm going to YOLO on this thing. At least got to keep.
Cool.
Shutting it off. Oh, yeah. Here it is. Big money.
Big money indeed. Oh, so close on that Morales. All right, I got a bail.
That's a victory for Morale.
There's the Mario Kart racetrack on our way out. There's stuff in the top.
Oh, damn it.
I'm going to lead these guys to mercenary camps if you can deal with that top there.
Yep, I got them on landing, dude. Oh, man, they got a wall. That's what I mean about this new meta, guys. He's like, oh, we're fighting, it's all good. And one minion wave wrecks your whole thing.
On the plus side, here's 10 for us. Now, let's see. Enemy team. Oh, you know what? They're probably going to do an entomb. So, sanctification would be totally sweet.
Yeah, it's definitely got to be Wailing Arrow. I'm going to get killed. Will I get killed with mind control? Oh, bot lane's going to need some wave clear.
It depends what you can grab, right? And actually, let's check Morales' talents, too. Did she defend herself, or did she...
It's just, I'll get focused and blowing up with mind control.
Yeah, I mean, and she's full block and everything, so...
We're going Arrow. Yeah, I gotta clear this bottom. I did end up going barb shot, so I've got increased damage to these guys.
Cool, looks like they got their terror, but they're still not 10 if we can get in a fight. But there's Nazebo, there's Skeleton King, Tychus Thrall. Yeah, they're. Looks like they're all heading top.
Yeah.
So what'll that be when they hit 10? Let's see. Let's see what we got. Alright, we'll need you. Looks like we're gonna go gank the tear. And we got ourselves an Entomb, a Gargantuan, a Sundering, Drill, and Stim.
Alright. All right, they backed off, huh?
Yep, we're just gonna dance a little bit here. It's a pretty decent height. I gotta run up with Kerrigan here.
Yep. They got all the seats, and they're using the terror to fight, so careful.
Smites.
Okay, there is a Tychus turret in here.
On the plus side, we're putting out a ton of... Oh, you're okay, stand your ground.
Nice, sorry, I'm getting all right. Safe location.
Those blocks, CCs and whatnot.
We got a flank, yeah.
I'm gonna lead him this way, do my little dance. Retreating. Don't worry about it.
Alright, we need someone else to grab it, I think. Or, you know what, it did fine with me grabbing it.
Yeah, we're trading a tank for a tank, though. I can totally do it. Want me to get it?
Yeah, go for it.
Alright, I'm on my way.
This thing's down.
Embrace your terror. Trust me. Such a weak cool. Fish. Better to be there's a Tychus in the bottom. Top needs a little bit of clearing. Did you need to back out? Yeah, you can use a little touch up. All right, so let's go clear top and make a problem.
Well, you go ahead. I'm gonna join you. Let Rainer get it. I'm not gonna save it in time. So you pick where you want to go.
Cool.
And try to play passive till I get there, because I can't shut down the towers. Even though you can, it will be helpful to have me there. Unless I split. Well, I've made the decision. It's too late now. Okay, shut it. If you can shut it off. Oh, yeah.
It's off. Seven seconds till the next one.
Okay.
Kerrigan's going pretty deep, though.
Damn it.
Yeah. I can do Thrall. I can get Thrall. Nope. Oh well, dancing in the Hyperion's not a bad idea either.
Yeah, we got a team fight.
Oh, I need to get some noise going right here. Get Kerrigan out. Alright, I'd like to hold on to this thing for the last bit so I can get some more stuff. That's a skin. Everyone bail. Oh well, Skeleton King.
Alright. Do we give? Is that real low? I'm coming for the team fight.
I'm gonna blow here if they kill me.
It's fine. Get on the Morales. I got Haunting Wave in a few seconds. Tank it.
You got her? Nice!
Oh, yeah.
There's a Rainer in the back here that could use a touch-up. Woo! I'm the bait! Oh, he's still going! Oh, he can't. Can he DPS through the drain? Okay. That was pretty wacky.
Oh, okay, I'm gonna get the siege.
What do we got? Drain Hope does damage if it completes. Grace of Air, that's not surprising. Tychus now heals. Nothing too crazy. I want to get people in the top, because that looks like where they're going, and we have two levels on them.
Yeah, the Lili keeps soloing.
She's Shadowpaw, man. It's what they do. You get that skin, and you just...
Yeah. Frick, I can't type. Oh, we're coming to join you.
I got a slow on the Zeebo. Are you okay back there?
Yep.
Cool.
Alright, and we're getting the heals.
Awesome. I'm going for that back line. Holy Ground is in!
Oh, except he pulled a ninja move.
Alright. So there's going to be a ghost dancing around us here, but we should be good. Tychus and Thrall are most likely coming. Actually, I can kind of leave that there.
Yep. Burn that down pretty
nice.
Quick.
To the bottom! Soon the garden terror will be
yours. I got to watch the Sunder in this choke point.
I do have...
Oh, damn. Okay, let's get a pick. We won't... Tychus?
We got Tychus, yeah.
Wow. Vulnerable, baby.
Alright, it's gonna come out. Stay on me. I'm gonna use it.
Yep, do it. Oh, it's so good with Kerrigan, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, and we still got some momentum here. I'm gonna shut off the towers.
Timer's ticking on that ride, so I'm on my way.
Okay, yeah. I'm super low, actually. I can go. It was better with me in it. Back out. Oh, you got it. Okay. Did we get two or just one on that fight? I've got a. Oh, you're here.
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna help them with this thing here.
Yep.
They're coming for it. We probably need you to team fight.
Yep, I'm swinging down. That's the Ford I want anyway. Ooh, I've got a Morales all by herself. This will certainly zone her out. Stim on the Tychus. I got a bail. Since that's all health percentage damage.
Oh, we've almost got him down. Alright, the Gargantuan's causing us trouble.
Timer's up, though. Alright, that's a Drain Hope. I gotta break that.
Shoot.
Oh, this Lily's so deep.
Right, we're coming. They're vulnerable. Yep. Wow, so much damage through the Morales heal. It's pretty hilarious. She's got to be low, right? Okay, they're down too. We take this. I can shut it down.
Nice, he used it during. Awesome.
And I'm backing out.
Cool.
Oh no.
Nope, I got you, I got you.
Alright, sweet. Oh no.
It's all good, all good. Let me die if it happens.
Oh, you know what? Carry
we just win.
Clean up crew on aisle.
We apparently. Cool.
Alright, we might need to disengage a little more.
Well, there's the Nizibo.
Oh my god. That was a great freaking holy ground or whatever.
That's a bit much.
Well, we do have a 3-level lead, but yeah, let's...
Yeah, I want to get these guys out.
Oh, they want to die, actually.
Yeah, if you can kill this guy. That's what Skeleton King's into, you know?
Oh.
I'm out of mana.
All right,
that's such a long time, but yeah, we got to back out.
We can get another Terror, I think, off of this, though.
Definitely.
Oh boy. Oh yeah, we'll get this in no time.
Great kid, don't get cocky.
I mean the Terror though.
Oh, not you, the other guy.
Oh. Everyone's friends when you're winning.
Right.
The choice between Bolt and Fury. Does anyone ever take Fury of the Storm, ever?
On Sylvanas?
Yeah.
I sometimes see Kristen take it on Spider Queen, just because it's the whole deal there.
I might just take Deafening Blast, so why not?
I think with this team, yeah, we're in a pretty good team fight position. I like this pick, and we can clear the top out. Let's see, there's 16. We got Imposing Presence on the Yorick Spiders, Blood for Blood, Overkill, does more damage to the primary target, and some Safeguarding. So really, Overkill is the only thing you have to worry about. Guess we loop down. Let's go kill them in their own camp.
Okay.
Because it's kind of the only thing on the map right now, and if they...
Go this way first so they don't get vision.
Definitely.
Ah,
they're already done. Whatevs.
Yeah. This is where we do have to be careful being caught out.
Yeah, I just saw Lily wandering off there. She was tempted.
It'd be real boring playing healers. You don't get to do the cool things.
Well, particularly when it death balls like this and the game becomes just play safe. It's so boring on healer. I really do feel their pain.
Are we trapping?
We're getting Lily in sight. I'm going to see their top at the moment.
Clearing up all of our work. Maybe I can just siege this mid while they're busy up top.
I'm going to stick around.
Yeah, they're going to come from the north side or the main door.
Yeah, I'm going to try to not encourage this too much. Okay.
Lily. Trying to tank. Okay, now it looks like they're splitting a little bit. Do we have anything proactive to do? Oh, Zebra's top lane.
Oh, there we go. That's something good.
I'm just gonna sit in the bush.
I can wall the door. What's going on in the back here? Okay.
Yeah.
It's just Rainer. Alright, now we can do stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
Now that we actually have a real life advantage.
Oh boy.
Almost objective. So I got 35 seconds and they're 20, but.
Can we not push this in?
We can, totally. I just need someone to turn it off. It's a little late now. We just needed some sort of.
They got a bit of a front line.
We need the switch pulled.
Alright, everyone's backed up.
Yep. And I know they're eager and they're nervous about 20, but we honestly, like.
Nope. Damn it. Here comes the orc.
Oh, Tychus.
Oh, yeah, there you go. Damn it, that freaking wall.
Yeah, gonna be a disengage for them. But you know, if he loops, nah, he's gonna loop through the top. I can't stop that, that's too big.
Yeah, we broke it off again. They may come back for the re-engage.
Yep, they're coming. Oh, Lili, stand in the invent run.
Zebra's just down. Oh, Kerrigan's still all right. Powerful. Alright, this is end.
Yep.
End time. End times.
This is the end times. I still have an entirely unused hardened shield.
See, Lili's like easy.
Yeah, right?
She only knew the kind of power that was playing on her team. Although, Lili life is easy. It's just hard not to get distracted.
Well, and you do have great damage, and it's easy to get caught up in lane clear, right? I mean, if you're Lili and you see the bottom getting pushed out, you got to control yourself to not go defend it, because you totally can. And you'll pull it off in a decent amount of time, but letting that fort fall and letting Zagara take care of it in a minute is probably the better decision.
I agree.
So that was... That was pretty cool.
So did they... Who did they... I'm just examining their team. Yeah, they had Nazebo. His siege was not very impressive, though. Although Nazebo's kind of a team fighty... he's a team fighty specialist. They did have the wave clear. But it just wasn't working. I think Kerrigan was pretty powerful in our
team. Yeah, Kerrigan actually managed to... And do really well there in the late game. She went with Sharpened Blade, Psionic Pulse, Assimilation Mastery, Double Strike. Yeah, so aggressive defense. Pretty much the build.
Although, but, really, she's better because of Sanctification. Like, that's just nuts. Like, it's unfair.
Yeah, well, and I was pretty proud of some Holy Grounds in there, too. So
yeah, you had some amazing Holy Grounds there.
That went pretty well.
That's what I mean by, I think, I've played with a lot of Kerrigans on my team. A lot of people at this league level know how to play her. Not a lot of people play Tyrael very well. So you're the difference maker. The other thing was,
again,
we have the duo queue. I'm just sort of trying to analyze like what went wrong for them, but I think the Kerrigan is strong. Our Rainer was really disciplined.
Yes.
About staying near you.
Yeah.
I never saw him out doing any weird things ever.
On a card to play, actually, which is an interesting pickup, but based on how the map went, it makes sense. More Hyperions, and we were getting the kills. Bullseye. You're right. He was very disciplined. He wanted to stay behind me the whole time. We had like to drag...
Compare him to Lili, who might be also someone who should stay near you.
Exactly. And I do feel bad. I do feel bad for Lili, because that you lose all your personality when you have death ball like that. But everyone relaxed, and we just win. We got the pick off on Nazebo, and we snowballed it into a win, and that's what needed to happen there.
I think that other truism about solo queue is also true. Duos are much stronger, generally. I think it'll be more favorable on your win rate to duo than to single queue.
I think
so. It seems obvious, but sometimes... You play with some people who do OQ where you question that knowledge.
Well, and there's some great experiments that have been done. Right now, I forget the streamer's name, one of the Russian streamers, but they've grabbed up an account donated to them with a negative Hotslogs MMR of -200.
Oh, wow.
And it has taken them 43 games. 42-1 is their score right now. And it's taken them that much to go from bronze 5 to silver 3. 42 games with one loss.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
That's a lot. Mind you, that's someone... It's still pretty discouraging, I think, for anyone who finds themselves that low.
Definitely.
Just to hear that one day you'll be good. In the best case scenario, you just get immediately good and you still have to win 100 games in a row.
But it does show
how
much one Grandmaster can do in a solo queue environment in the lower leagues, but that does taper off at a point. There's just not as many mistakes to take advantage of. I'm banning. What do we want?
First pick, do you play KT and carry? It's important to ask both, because if you say or, then they show you one, and then you assume they can play both, and then you find out they can't, you pass Kerrigan over to them. So, carry's the ban.
Okay, so, yep. Yeah. Let's get rid of that Kerrigan. KT or Ming, he's old school now. Welcome back, Grandpa, from the two-week-old meta, jeez.
KT or Ming is so 2 minutes ago. We're up against the Dirty D. That's great. Maybe I should play Medivh. Alright.
So they got rid of Zul for Tomb of the Spider Queen. That's a good map-dependent thing to get rid of. So we'll have a KT, huh?
That means they're likely to have a Ming. Or a Zagara. And a Zagara.
Yeah. The nice thing about Tyrael is I can be solo tank and highly responsive. It's what I like in a Nubarak, but a Nubarak needs something else. He needs that main tank. So it's not bad with the KT, but if we don't have a dive, it's just I'm keeping up with no one but myself, and it's not worth it. So I guess for now I'll highlight over the Diablo. Even the Tracer doesn't scare me too much on Diablo. Well, the Thrall. That's quite a bit.
Let's see. Tracer. We're going to need a plan for the Tracer.
Yeah. Yeah, and Tomb of the Spider Queen has such wide halls that I really can't stun lock her well on Tomb of the Spider Queen. Oh, interesting.
I'm just hovering over things. Don't take them as decisions.
We actually... Okay. I thought we were relieved of duty for a moment. With a gray main, though...
We're going to need the specialist. We're going to need,
Yeah, and then I'll get support.
Unless you... I can support if you have a specialist you want to play.
Nah, you take it. My specialist practice has been so... lacking recently.
I've played a number of games on Zagara, mind you. Actually, Zagara might... Hunter Killer might be good to put on Tracer. It'll just zone her out, if not, kill her.
Yeah. So they got rid of the Rengar. That's fine.
What do we want?
I'm not banning Brightwing. I'm probably going to pick Brightwing.
Do we hate Johanna here? There's a chance they pick up Zags, but I can play Zebras or Syl.
I don't think ETC is particularly powerful, but I think it's safe to get rid of. So near JoJo, huh?
I can Ma.
I think JoJo has a lot more implication. Oh, wait. It's fine. It's fine.
Yeah. The thing is, ETC, I can Ma when he moshes.
Yeah, very true. Okay, so they grabbed up the Brightwing, huh?
We have a tank, though. Oh, yeah. Oh, that's... You picked it because...
Yeah, no, you get the Zagara. You get the Zagara, certainly. I'm just trying to figure out.
Are you good with Segura?
No, you get her, man.
Okay, because I can do that too, potentially. I don't think I like it. Oh, I do like it versus Tracer, but...
Yeah,
well,
I can do the Monk.
Yeah, if you do the Insight build with the Folly of Blows?
No, I do Transcendence right. And then Wave 100 Fists.
Yeah, you do you. I'm not going to tell you how to pick your character, but I've been playing Carl Jim Insight.
Cool. I was actually practicing quite a bit of Karazim this week, so...
He can really truck damage and be an effective healer. Like, taking Insight... Not that I recommend you do it if you're not comfortable with it, but stacking the 100 stacks, your heal, as long as you're punching, you have permanent deadly reach, the uptime on your heals is really, it's a more effective healing, I think, than stacking healing talents.
Man, if it wasn't for that Tracer, it would have been great to just Morales this thing.
Yeah, but I mean...
I'm not even that afraid of Thrall or Muradin jumping me, just Tracer spinning me.
I don't know how effective it would be, but I'd be very tempted to get a Carl Jim in game to Volley of Blows, a Volley of Blows style build. Like, I'd still go Palm. I always go Palm, but I always take Volley of Blows.
Yeah, definitely.
Just because I've had my past experience, Carl Jim is super effective against Zeratul, which is sort of similar to Tracer. Hmm. Because you've got already somebody doing damage, but that extra support damage to help DPS more.
Yeah.
And there's no missing. You Q the Zeratul, he takes the damage. There's no, you know, there's no tomfoolery. All right.
Basic attack restores mana once you have stacks.
Okay, I'm going infested drop build.
That is pretty cool. For me, I've been playing quite a bit of him this week and practicing enough, so I'm excited to bring him in here, but it's been a scary experience in the past. But Wave of 100 Fists, if I don't need cleanse, just gets me in the right mindset, I guess you could say. It puts me in the good mental place that I want to be in.
Yep, no, go with what works. Alright, so I've got to establish...
See. We've got a Polymorph, which I probably can't cleanse. A Thrall, which I don't think there's really... We can watch... it's Mind Control, though, at 10. Cool. Sounds good to me. You're in the bottom versus Zagara. Thrall's already going in the top, so I'm going to make my way up there.
They're going to diligently clear creep. Boo. Muradin's going to try and get his ganks on me. Muradin does a scary amount of damage.
He does. But I'm glad that he is getting his role further defined. Getting his own personality rather than just the every tank for everything kind of guy.
That's true. I'm not disappointed by it. It's just when I play against him sometimes, I definitely underestimate.
He's also got a really weird power spike at 13.
The Grey Mane just underestimated it. This guy is playing super aggressive. Oh no! They're all coming to gank.
Nice job getting out. You guys, what about it, man? I go. Okay. That's pretty esports, Captain.
Isn't the whole thing for the four guys to... It's true, they are focusing pretty hard on bot lane. And I'm Because actually, what if I rotated top?
Looks like KT's coming down to take your spot.
I mean, I guess the problem is that leaves bottom lane naked versus Sylvanas.
Well, I'm more concerned about you just being off creep and having to set up in a new area, but if they were clearing you out anyway.
No, I'm cleared out. Like, that's the thing, is they're firmly camping bottom while you guys have control of the top, so.
What's going on right there? Is Diablo gonna make it? Looks like it. Hmm. taking protective shield because Diablo.
Man, that's super annoying. Yeah, we're gonna have to play pretty kitey.
And what's going on in the top here?
Oh.
Come on, walk it. Alright, I'm not soaking anymore. These guys are... They require attention.
Oh my god. Urgh. Smurting keeps hunting me. It's super annoying.
We've got three of them in the top, so...
Yeah, no, I'm not dying to him too hard. It's just... He's just really passionate about trying to hit me with his hammer.
How's Greymane doing?
He's doing real well, actually helping protect me.
Mid is pushed out for the minute. I've got 10 on me.
I'm gonna get blown up.
Brightwing's heading down bot, but we still got Thrall up here. And Tracer's in the mid.
I almost got Murden.
I don't know, dude. Because you're 10%. Everything's ruined. Get off my lawn, Greymane.
There's a turn in mid. Alright, cue to me if you need to. Well, does that mean we have a 30% chance to win now?
That was first catapults, not spiders,
okay.
Right?
All right. Phew.
Oh, Greymane, right. You're so beef, bro. It's like Kael'thas has control of the bottom for now.
Yeah, all five of them are up here, though. Oh, nicely done.
He touched the wall. Waves are building.
Okay.
Oh, don't die to a gray mate. Okay.
I'm headed up top.
Yeah, that was pretty swiftly dealt with.
Yep. Oh, here's Tracer.
I have a sneaking suspicion this is going to come down to how good my palms are.
Okay.
Because with their amount of burst... I mean, we have burst too, but it... They definitely have the grab a guy and kill him. We both do with Diablo.
It's also going to depend on the power of the Maws. Because I'm definitely going Maw. There's no need for network here, I don't think.
No, with Kael'thas and Greymane even, we can lane clear well enough. We lost Wrath. Who was Wrath? Wrath is Diablo. Diablo's a computer.
Alright. Maybe I'll come back.
They do have 10.
He's back.
Cool. Kael'thas is getting a little locked down.
Oh. Shit.
Oh, Diablo's still going.
Top lane is still being... Oh. I'moom.
Cool.
I can't maw.
I think we're all out.
Oh, shit, mid lane. Poopy. Sweet, two forts on that? That's
yeah.
Not bad.
Not too bad. Lost a little bit of wall, but that's okay.
Still pretty good.
We're sitting on a ton of gems right now.
Looks like they're mostly top, so turning bot might be good.
The wait for Zag part. Yeah, I agree. Bot's the safer, but I got a gray main up here.
Okay. I'm reporting two dance floors. All right, I've got to turn in, so play carefully. I'm not going to join you guys.
Cool. We're backing out right now. The main turning is done.
Oh,
that's a deep diab. Wow, great charge, though. Need a touch up on Kale. Sweet. Sylvanas looks like she's by herself. If we can get the troops up there.
No, I'm just sort of
someone else.
No. She's out. She's out. She pushed in the lane. She did what she wanted to up here.
I'm back on Grey Main duty then.
Yep. Be your babysitting Grey Main.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, I'm coming to join for this.
Cool, I soaked the polymorph.
Okay, there is a...
There was the palm out.
We didn't kill Burden. Man, we got him so close. Okay, I need to find a place to...
Oh. I'm a Bob. I gotta back out. There's nothing safe to punch.
I got a mop. I'm just looking... We had a... I had an opening, but not really. Need the healing farts. You have double fart, or you got cleanse?
No, I did the... My punches. Cool. Nice. That little dance cost them their ults, which is pretty awesome. Let's do relentless for me now, and I can start soaking...
Oh, Grey Main in a bit of trouble. Damn it, that Tracer.
Yeah. She's out of recall, though. I mean, I've got 8 on me, so we're going to get turned in.
Middle of something's going on here.
Yeah, Diablo's kind of baiting them up and around. Definitely wants to do it. There's Grey Main as well.
I mean, Murden's position is so... He's not vulnerable, but it's like, it's real aggressive.
He's using his leap well, though, so...
Oh, no.
That should be okay.
Ma. Oh, shit. I can't ma. Still gonna...
Come on, die, you bastard.
Silence. I mean, I got Thrall on the ma.
Cool. We got all of the gems back out, too. Looks like we're pursuing Tracer.
Yeah.
Nice. Agreement. And Diablo's back up. Hey!
So, as it turns out, Grey Main may be nerfed, but the R button is still, the win button.
They did get rid of the range on it, though, and I'm curious to know. Yeah. I need to get in Quick Match and try that out before I go applying myself in Hero League. I wish we would have saw it sooner. We could have taken a boss. We all kind of turned in there. I'm going to go ahead and...
Yeah, it might be a good idea to siege a bit. Here they come. Yeah, if you need mana, now's a good time.
I try to use abbreviations to try to make everything more casual, but the more I communicate, the more bossy I feel, so I need to find a balance.
Yeah, so when you use big words, people are like, oh, look, it's Big Words McGee over here. Thinks he's so good with big words.
Like, it's not, it's ain't. We gotta keep the fun going. Everything's got to be spelled in, like, wacky mom-and-pop shop.
So we have a... Let's turn in. Somebody... Because they're probably turning in. Although, I've got vision up there.
Yeah, you've
so
got vision
not.
In the top. Yeah. It was the 34 on Muradin that really bumped him up there. Oh. Looks like Thrall's heading to the top. Nope, he's back. He's back in the mid.
There's a Brightwing.
And they're divided. If we can...
I literally have... Oh my god.
I would love 16.
All right, we can't turn these in. Or, never mind.
There we go.
Not with that attitude, Gorath, we can't. We'd have a winning attitude.
KT's all, right. all the way up here, so I'm going to be floating nearby. Diablo wants to do the middle.
Oh, there's something. Yeah, he looks. I think Tracer's over here. Watch it. I need to clear this.
Cool. If we can get a keep off of this, that would be fantastic.
I think pushing top lane might be correct, but let's clear this wave.
Looks like Diablo agrees with it. So I'm going to angle my body up here and suggest a similar thing. Yep. Let's do top.
Tracer might be around. Oh, yeah. Punch that Tracer. Feels good, right?
It does feel good.
It does a good chunk because she has a low health pool. Oh, here we go.
Yeah, Murden in the back. Oh, that'll be a punch for you.
That's fine. They're trying to do fancy stuff.
They are, aren't they?
Oh, damn it.
Oh, KT again. Oh, well. I'm a bomb. Oh, no. Recall damage. Aw.
That means I'm going to go down too.
Well, your Greymane's brave. Oh, the poison damage. I think you can make it.
No.
Oh, no. Ah.
So the problem was they all came from behind us and not everyone turned around to deal with it.
Oh. Greymane.
No, it's not entirely his fault.
No.
He came from behind us, and I actually saved him from the Thrall who just zeroed in on him. Like, without any peel, what's he going to do?
I mean, I wish he would have, you know,
his damage is super.
Taken the heal. And who knows, maybe he felt pressured for the KT, and some people don't want to say no, but it's okay to say no. I can't do that. I'm guessing they'll go mid, so we should be good. Wow, does she actually charge that while walking? I've never seen that before.
What's that?
She was charging her little wave there while she was walking towards us.
Who's Zagara?
Nah, the Spider Queen.
Oh, I didn't notice, actually. Yeah, actually, it's doing it down here now that you mention it.
I've never seen that before.
It looks like a bug.
Whoa, it's infinite. Okay, so it's not activating. I'm dancing back here like we're about to get waved.
Okay, take the safe way.
Ooh, nice little murder camp. We gotta make sure they don't go boss. You have a little bit of sight there.
No,
there's a Tracer, there's Murden. Okay, we're good. This is kind of a scary thing to be doing.
They got 40 coins. They must be turning in somewhere.
Yeah. Who's got the coins? Murden and Brightwing in the bottom. I've got two on me. We've only got 29 total. There's Murden. There's a Thrall, actually.
That Thrall is super out.
Yeah, sadly.
I think their team would catch up quick enough.
Yeah, well.
We may be able to fool them into thinking we're trying to boss.
I think we've got the right comp for it. We're better off trying to bush them.
Although it looks like we're just going to lane safely.
Yeah.
Turtle up. To roll the dice on the fight, it looks like. Oh, look at. Oh, shit. No! Freaking.
Oh, no, Diablo's too deep.
Oh, he got Haymaker. Oh, he's up.
Yeah, he's okay. Oh, well, Thrall just completely whipped his thundering in the wrong direction. They need five more for a turn in. So Sylvanas is going to try to turn in here. Dirty D.
Oh, she's got a lot, too. Oh, can we make anything happen up here?
I'd like to believe so.
Oh, no, here they are. They're looking like they want a boss.
Yeah, or at least
they have a number of ultimates on cooldown.
Yeah, the Sundering is at the very least.
Well, here I go. I'm going down because look at this.
Well, you took someone with you.
No, there we go. It's another one. Tracer, if you can cue to her.
Nice.
Go heal. Go heal. They'll be fine.
Bows it.
Alright, well, it worked out, even though I cried and complained through the whole thing.
Well, getting haymakers never fun.
No. Well, I was more sad about the Maw, because it would have been fine, but...
Yeah, the Emerald Wind.
That wind got me. Wind's pretty powerful alt.
It is. It is. And in comparison to what Blinkheel's putting out these days, it's definitely tempting to start putting the chickens...
We have to be able to farm enough gems for turning.
We got 12 seconds, though. I'd really love to take that top keep. But yeah. Boss is best used to get us a turn in.
Indeed it is.
All right, oh, we have a flat 30 left, so I gotta turn myself in here. Oh, and that'll be the keep. Nice. Barely got it.
Somebody needs to turn in their 30.
It's Gray.
I'm gonna go set up vision because it looks like we're gonna be turning in down.
Well, Diablo knows his job. He's getting out in front. There we go. Nice. And they're pretty organized.
Now, you just need to be patient.
Yep. Wait for the spiders. Diablo should have enough souls maybe at this point. I think he might be a little light. I wish I could see that, but I know I care about Diablo more than most people probably.
You're like, just because you know all the nuance, right?
Exactly.
Like, he doesn't understand this nuance. What a loser. All right.
Yeah, Murden's just trying to poke out a good position for a haymaker.
Oh, yeah, that's definitely something to be worried about.
That dance he's doing.
There it goes. Big Maw, big money. Nobody went down with all that Baneling spam.
I think we'll get the murdered. There we go.
Oh, Tracer's on Grimmint. Nice. Good palm.
I need to punch things. I need things to punch.
Well, we keep distracting them here. We let the other ones do their job. And I've got super infested drop.
Nice.
That's good.
I mean, Murden's down. Okay, here we go. There's the break. As Sylvanas heads to D the bottom.
That's 30 seconds to get a kill and push this core friend.
Yeah, I'd love to stagger. I want to get Greymane on the correct side. There's a fort in the bottom, too.
There's a pick. He's only got Emerald Wind, so it should be a kill. I got Maw again.
Cool. I got to guard Greymane.
Rag, I missed everything. All right, just core. Rush it.
Yeah, nice. Way to target me. Yes. GG.
Patience in this game.
Yeah, right? That's what we learned today anyway.
We took a wipe, and we didn't let it tilt us.
Is to take it real slow.
Man, Zagara's pretty awesome.
That's good. I'll have a hard time not running away with that. I love Monk, and I feel like I'm constantly leashing myself. Because his damage is so low, like even though he punches things to heal, like you can just go Lili, put out the same healing numbers and the blinds and everything else, but the responsiveness you have. And I knew Greymane and Kael'thas would always be at two separate ends of the team fight, and the ability to move so freely between them and target exactly what you want is very powerful. In fact, I outhealed the enemy.
Karazim is super strong, and if you're really good with them, the the high end on him is really good.
Yeah, it's so easy to get zoned out, though, and just feel like I can't punch.
Yeah, if you're not punching, then that's a problem. So he's, like, not a good pickup in certain situations, but I don't know. He's a tough little cookie. It's like a small package that is... What is it? Good things come in small packages kind of thing? Like, yeah, he's... He definitely did... You had some good palms in that one. And I pushed Hunter Killer a lot.
Well, yeah. Oh, so okay. So let's see your specs. So you did go Corpse Feeder for the drop.
Yeah.
But then, right, it's level 7 that starts the quest. That's such a weird one.
Yeah, it doesn't take too long to get it. I get it pretty reliably. And even without, even just if you don't complete the quest, you get the 10% bonus damage.
Hmm.
I think this might be a meta shift once people understand to dodge the drop, but people don't dodge it.
Well, if you're also, going Maw, you also have a chance to control that battlefield and line it up correctly.
And all, but also, you know how you do the Maw and spam Banelings and Infested drop?
Yeah.
Like before you, it's better now. It's there. I'm not sure what they did. It wasn't in a patch note that I saw, but Infested drop feels more responsive than it used to be.
Interesting. It always was. I mean, you don't even have to stop moving. Infested drop, that's the treatment I want for Arthas's Death Coil. Like the fact that he has to stop at all and regain his acceleration is such a detriment there. And Zagar just keeps running, but you say it's even more so now.
Yeah, no, the best part about him right now is Infested drop, I find. It just hitting people. I find I'm hitting people better. And I like to say, oh, I've improved its skill at the game, but there's a feeling I'm getting from the client that it's actually just better to use.
Yeah.
And I just enjoy hitting people on the noggin with it now that I'm able to do it more reliably. I feel like it does... It's the burstiest damage she has now, where I think pre her changes, not because that wasn't this last patch, but maybe the one before, it felt like it kind of did nothing. It was wet noodle style, right?
Mm.
The drop actually can do considerable damage, and people right now don't dodge it as much. So
yeah, you don't watch for it. It's not on my radar when I'm picking out abilities at the start of a game.
Right, so people tend to take, even when they see the little thing on the ground, which is kind of hard to see in a big fight, but still, they don't walk out of it. They usually face tank that.
Well, and like, it's purple, and Tomb of the Spider Queen's purple, so clearly you took this hero for the color advantage, much like we'd want maybe Chromie's abilities on Sky Temple, because they're all yellow.
You're saying I'm a cheater? All right.
No, you're playing to the game, man. That's it.
Camouflage is real.
Right? Gul'dan, best win rate on Blackheart's Bay, and because of green, it gets lost. No one's it's not true. I don't even really know what his best win rate is right now.
Yeah, I recommend you take Zagar out. She's always been strong, but she feels stronger if that's even possible.
I used to do it a lot in the past, but creep sight really tilts me when I do it well, and then people don't take advantage of it. So I just avoided it for fun.
Well, this is the fun thing. If you go mob build, your creep sucks.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
So you're less invested. Like, my creep got cleared all the time. And I was like, I don't care. Like, the reason I'm playing Zagar is for Maw and Infested drop. And, like, I'm using it for vision, but, like, the way Lunara uses vision, which is, like, drop a creep tumor, hope to see something. Or put a creep tumor here if I need an escape, and this is my planned escape route. And if they clear it, they clear it. Whereas I think if you go the Nidus build, that's the one where you get the creep spread, and you're doing it for vision.
Yeah.
Like, your level, like, because I get it, because it's like creep. I get all the vision. It's super powerful, except it's countered by diligent players. And the higher up in ranks you go, the more diligent people are.
Mm. But I'm going to Dragonshire. It feels so lonely. But I can be first pick now, so that's kind of nice. We're going to inform the people that I am a bad KT. So we're going to go and get rid of Kerrigan there. Early picking something else. This is part of my commitment to type more. So they got rid of Sylve. Dragonshire too. Cool. This realm needs me. Dirty, let me get the Li Ming. Just didn't want to steal it without any sort of permission done. We certainly have things to practice in the background now. I mean, here's another first pick, Zagara. And Gorath was certainly selling it pretty well. So we'll see what happens in the future. As always, I love Li Ming as an early pick. Regardless of her win rate right now, she's still in a great spot. I love how much I can vary my build. Here, we're probably going to use Teleport to get away from the Hunter Killer and dodge Blizzards. So this will not be a Calamity build at the moment. I'll be using those for mobility. We can Calamity on top of the Hydralisk and just destroy it. But there's still the Jaina to concern ourselves with. So Dragonshire, we got orbs available. So some Power Hungry, perhaps. You know, actually, we might be able to. We got Thrall and Falstad, yeah? Well, that's pretty good. So now it's just up to Nakata and Piccolo to finish us out. But definitely power hungry. And if these guys stay pretty immobile, we could do a little bit of mirror ball business. So what's it gonna be? Tracer. Okay. Complicates my shots a bit, but I think we can still blow her away at times. ETC. We'll have a Murid and a Sundering, probably a Gust. Brightwing is still in play. Okay, Uther actually got banned out. Wow. Didn't even know the ETC was coming, and we got rid of Uther. Nice job. That looks pretty good. We have a lot of interrupts for the Mosh then. Ready for action. I think that looks pretty good. ETC shouldn't be a problem. I think the Tracer's for me, right? That'd be my biggest concern. But we're not going to do a Calamity. Plus, I would just jump in range for her to melee smack me. I don't want to make that investment. Can also Arcane Orb this. What's our front line like? Muradin, Thrall, Falstad. Well, we'll go Power Hungry and see how people are moving and how I'm actually aiming the magic missiles today. I think that'll be the best place to base it off of. Some days you just can't aim things. And we'll see what happens. Wait until you see what I can do. So let's grab that Power Hunger, as there will be plenty of orbs in our area. My knowledge increases. Jaina, Tracer, Zagara, ETC, and Rhaegar. Both teams have the potential to win the middle, I think. 10 seconds. I think in a flat, like, everyone starts at the starting line and runs at each other, though. I think we win the mid, so we're right to pile in here. Let the battle begin. And Falstad sets up early. There's a power slide. That's a hit. Ooh, nice little dance by Tracer. Not highly informative, but we'll see what happens in the future. Nice pickup. Hydra's wailing on me, though. Let's see if we can get out Tracer. And we don't have a way to clear creep on Li Ming without Calamity. Neither does Thrall, really, actually, so. So far, we're pretty good on our aim today. Oh, she got readjusted. Ah, bummer. Ooh, close one. Good thing they didn't have a level lead. Thrall's battling it out in the top. They have tank and support in the bottom, though, so let's... Nope, Brightwing's already up there with Thrall. I'll go in on the mid, then. See if we can get Li Ming loaded up. Don't know where Tracer is at the moment. There she is. Nice, she walked right into it. Oh, but Rhaegar's here. Here comes Thrall. Ah, oh, we lost bot control, huh? Alright, let's make our choices. For now, though, I don't think this is a team... Yeah, that I really get in melee range for, so let's just do Triumvirate. Top is missing. I don't think they're going to get control of it, though. I'm a little surprised that Muradin exploded there. We can power up my health here. They are going to lose control. It seems like my travels never okay. I've got the teleport. Sadly, no one's in range to... Oh, Muradin misses stun! Hey, okay, we got it. We got it. Yeah, darn. The darn dragon is applying himself a little too hard and burning all that health. Oh, man. That's always a shame. You gotta relax. Wait for some friends. Oh, don't be like that, man. Don't be like that. Alright, no. We didn't get a response. That's okay. Let's get back in lane then. We're gonna do Seeker. Just doing a sort of raw damage build. That was all you, Captain. You were all by yourself there. Brightwing 2. Okay, so looks like ETC has taken the reins and is leading everyone around pretty thoroughly, actually. Kind of scary. There's another two-heading bot as well right now. They're not expecting it. I have to agree with the Falstad. It's pretty predictable biz. These aren't surprising moves. Well, here comes Muradin. I don't think we can really control that. Muradin wants to take a bottom camp though. And ETC definitely wants to power slide us. Who we're missing. Okay, so Tracer's in the middle. We don't know where Zag is, but... We forced him out. We're missing Thrall. They do have 10. There's Zag. Where'd Tracer go? Oh, Murden's zoning her out. Oh, that's nice. I think we're good. What's the other ultimate, actually? Okay, Haymaker, huh? But we have the Earthquake. Close one, brah. Alright, Murden's up top now. Whoa, how did he get all the way up there? Did he die? That's a long way to walk. Let's wait till we see ETC. There he is. And he's dancing round. Well, he's not there for a moment. Oh, nope. Bummer. Oh, I didn't expect the Rhaegar. That's on me. I thought we might be able to get in there for my dudes. Well, first death, but bad time to have it. Rather die 3 times in the early game and then just stop dying. A long time to be out of the fray. And now we're gonna have to do that. Dirty, what you doing, Dirty? Dirty, help out your brother. What is it? Is it like elementary school? Your hand goes up, your eyes turn off? Or ears turn off is what the teachers used to say. You get busy hearthing and you stop paying attention? Oh dear. But I'm luckily out of the blizzard. Thrall has been pulled up top by the Zagara. Oh no, this is gonna be a full-on doodiddle. Alright, despite my... I really want to go deal with this bottom! Okay. Well, to get a hold of me, I'm already dead. So let's do Glass Cannon. We're a big part of our team's damage. So I'm not usually a fan of it, but here, I'm screwing up if I die. I'm already out of position, if it comes to that. Well, that's pretty cute, but making something happen off it's the hard part. Oh, brutal, guys. Thrall's clearly, I think he's checked out. So let's see. Let's see how hard we can carry. Without, you know, actually getting in range to get snagged by stuff.
Soon the shrine's shadow awakens.
Oh, that took a while. Yeah, good on them. They don't care about us. And rightfully so. Oh, he's had such a pretty comp. I think you'll regret this. And Brightwing's okay to soak down there, of course. Because she can teleport in on the biz as it breaks out, but she's not going to be able to solo push that, of course. And I doubt she'll be able to hold that, so we're going to have to... We don't get deep enough here. Yeah, we're just going to have to tank a dragon. Oh, my auto attacks aren't going to scare him off. Let's get in the base. Not three level down auto attacks, anyway. How did he get over the wall, actually? In perfect honesty. Oh, Haymaker? Oh, it must have been, yeah. But no, Haymaker doesn't go over buildings, does it? Oh, nope, that was wrong. Doing good damage. Oh, that's a good one. That was a good Gust Thrall. Oh my goodness, man. Pay attention. All right, into the bottom. I mean, we need to make something rather amazing happen. So let's see if we can get these guys to get a fort. There's a Tracer still around. But this is our time to get business done. This was the time to get the business done. Sadly, Falstad does need to heal after that. Yeah, we need something to get them... Well, you know, I guess we'll just... Alright, Thrall wants to take this, right? That took too long to say, and we canceled our hearth. Bummer. Oh wait, no, that's great. That's great, actually. I thought I just heard ding and got depressed. I need to pay attention. Well, that's a shame. What, Thrall? You're gonna bully the Brightwing now, man? That's not how you win. I guess I could have died with you. Nice. Well said. Oh, this creep. Bummer. I don't... If they go down the middle, actually, it's not GG yet. Okay, there it goes into the bottom. But if I can reliably... Actually, nice little haymaker there. Is ETC on the inside? that's honestly who I want on the inside. That Rhaegar is real low too. Catapults. But now it's an ETC. Oh, well. Thus it goes. Thrall Feedmaster, says Beastmaster. Well, he would be the one to name out the masters, at least, as a fellow master himself. But let's see what the numbers look like during that particular one. Hey! Daily quest completed. Okay, so we weren't favored, so we lost a few less points in that one. Pretty good damn. Wow. Quite the divide. 6 deaths. 8 deaths. So if we look at the team comps objectively, maybe Brightwing doesn't really support this? If we're just looking at team comps and nothing else, right? Jaina, Zagara, Tracer, ETC, Rhaegar. Because it's a good comp. With the Murd and Thrall Falstad Li Ming, I thought we would do pretty darn well there, but we got completely smashed, didn't we? 20 assists on their ETC, I think, really brought them together and gave them a very obvious place to look. And we tried to round about the ETC a bit, but 3 levels up, laying all those magic missiles into him wasn't the right thing during the mosh pit, but I mean, there's so many creeps around, what else do you do? Me with my 1 death, because I missed a Rhaegar on the mini-map and end up exploding there. Not a crucial moment, though, and lived. So what could we do? And I didn't even die when I had the glass cannon. That was well before, back around 7 or so, I think. I mean, clearly Thrall was... I'm not dodging that Thrall apparently wanted to argue. But if we're fixing the comp, perhaps, like, why Haymaker? Why did we have a Haymaker when we had a Mighty Gust? And there's no giant killers. I think Rhaegar can get himself a butt giant killer, right? At some point, maybe? Oh, the Zagara could have done a giant killer. But she went mutilus, so... odd choices all around. All right, we are second. Oh my goodness, that is quite the name. Silvermind shall not slow down. And Hydralisk. Enemy team is banning, giving my team some time to wake up. Let's see, Tomb of the Spider Queen. We're back on Tomb of the Spider Queen, are we? They'll get first pick. Looks like a Gul'dan last pick. I mean, I guess that's where we want him. First pick Kerrigan. Hovering there. If we get the Kerrigan, maybe we can Tyrael again. Specialist meta, Zul and Zagar out. Out and out early. They got the Kerrigan. Okay. Let's see. Kael'thas then. You'd like to pick someone that can void her area pretty quick. It's Lunara. I guess let's just do a general pickup for my team. We don't really know what's going to happen, what the healers are going to be. I mean... it's tempting to go something like a Nubarak or Skeleton King just so we can abandon the area around Kerrigan. That's going to be our big problem on Diablo here. But these guys currently aren't looking like they're going to pick up any supports or another tank for me. So we'll go ahead and get that out of the way. I think Cry-D is hoping to force Gul'dan into supporting. Another ETC, that's fine. I can deal with that. And I would like to have a specialist. I mean, Lunara can cover it. But if we have another specialist, that just means that... Interesting ban, huh? Really odd ban. I think we might want that Brightwing for our support. Let's go ahead and do the cautious thing and prod Yerbade Nephilim. Right, Nephilim? Interesting, they get rid of Thrall, but they don't see our leaving. And now we're gonna play chicken. As Cry-D tries to get... I'd rather have most of the things Cry-D is showing rather than a Gul'dan. Are you playing Gul'dan even if I play support? Well, looks like Yerbade won the chicken race. It's Tomb of the Spider Queen. We need... Here we go again. And there's a Chromie now. But I don't think this guy is going to change his tone. It's an arcane orb, though, so it doesn't clear super well. And he hasn't moved, so we'll just have to let it happen. I mean, since he locked in, he hasn't shown a single other hero, so we don't even know what specialist he might be sporting. Sylvanas is out, Zula's out, Zagara's out. So, Chromie, huh? We're not getting back to her. Maybe the Lunara can poke her out. But Chromie, Sylvanas, Kerrigan, etc. This will probably be my classic death build. I got a pretty squishy team. And Gul'dan is my off tank, but we can't, because if he takes damage, then his DPS is decreased. And if he takes damage, he's gonna have to life tap at some point, so we really can't let the Gul'dan take any damage. He's gotta be able to life tap himself. And that stun on Kerrigan in the pool too is gonna ruin his drain life. So I really question, I'm excited to see Gul'dan. I love the guy. I want to be the one taking him into these games, in fact, you know? He got a buff today on Fell Flames. So this may work out. Tyrande's kind of a scary healer to put out. My job is really important, is the thing. I have no real leeway to mess up. All my deaths have to be extremely well-timed. And we're gonna die with a Chromie and a Kerrigan in the game. I don't think we win this middle fight. They win the middle burst, so I'm gonna try to keep my guys in the back here. There's ETC trying to poke something out. Alright, there's Breath. There's a Kerrigan. We'll probably just The first mistake has been made. Out from Chromie. Lenara's heading top. That is a wrong assessment, but I understand your frustration. I was not protecting you back there. I was trying to dissuade you. Pretty good. I am without a well, though, and Tehran is not exactly the one to top me off here. I do have good regeneration on Diablo, though, so let's see if we can get some orbs. But if I take a sandblast, we're out of here. Is that Kerrigan gonna leap? Cool. With Kerrigan down, the dive should be slightly reduced. So be it. Let's see. Business going on in the top. Looks like bottom's been doing all right this whole time. I doubt we'll get Rhaegar to make a similar mistake as the last one. Oh, Gul'dan. I don't think I can get there fast enough for him. He's doing a good wiggle, though. Actually, you know what? He actually did live. Cooldowns, cooldowns, cooldowns. Let's get back to this busyness. ETC moving to the bottom at the moment. That should be some good hits for his quest if he's questing. If he's questing, no, it's going to be a spam build. Kerrigan's heading top. Cool, job done there. My dudes are soaking well. We seem to be shepherding pretty well so far. These lanes are just so giant. It's tough to get my good angles done. There's Sylvanas in the bottom. ETC heading top. There's a sandblast. Still cost him the power. Oh! You want to keep walking, Kerrigan? Nah. Oh, it's a good hit. There's gonna be another one in a second here, so let's abandon the straight lines. Now Sylvanas is gonna want to turn in the bottom in this lull in action. Let's just do my good old-fashioned friend, Diabolic Momentum. I still think she's going to try to angle around. Nope, she doesn't. Okay. There we go. Okay, there's the angle. Whatever. Job accomplished. Oh, it's going to get busy here. Kerrigan down, though. Okay. All right, she wants to go top, but she also kind of wants to turn in bot. This world will burn. I mean, we all want to be everywhere at once. I guess we let it happen. Yeah, we had to abandon that. Should have stayed down there. Oh, well. At least that's the gems gone. Let's stop this, everybody. I just need a little bit of damage with me. Cool, here comes Li Ming. Oh, I guess my toe was in it. Oh, well, we'll have a turn in as soon as this is done. Alright, let's get in on this. I would like to get... Tirana's doing a good job. Alright, we got 3, 4. This should be enough for me to get in, as long as nothing brings us up this way. Oh my goodness. Oh, those gems. All right, let's see. I can do this. Nope, Kerrigan's gonna guard him well. This is probably a communication problem. Yeah, that's... Oh. That hurts. Oh, second one in a row. Gross. Alright. We got the damage to deal with it, though. By no means do we lose. But we need 20 souls. And there's probably a mosh pit. Well, you know, no one's in range of it, actually. Oh, that's for me. I do have the souls, though. Nice. All right, let's clean up fast before we lose forts. Okay, bail. That bottom's going, isn't it? But no catapults. Alright, what we need is map control in the bottom back. But we have help for this. Okay, we got turned in. Our Tyrande's down for it, but as soon as she's up, she can heal us, so that's something. I think I gotta spell shield this, though. So no bonus damage for me today. Chromie's heading top. She's keeping to the... Oh, Gromies, man. Gross. We're back, though. We're alive. Oh, no. That's a good mosh. While Kerrigan wails on my dudes. Nice. Okay. Recovery. Nope, stick around with me. Come on. Let's do this top. Let's do a boss. We got 21 seconds, man. 21 seconds. Nope. Okay. It's a bit slow. We need damn. Oh. Nothing. Okay, we can turn in again. That's very true. I've got a long time on the next one, though. I got enough souls, though. I do have enough souls. We need the damage and range. Look at that. Lunara right there. If I can get her, if I can get her something to wail on. Oh, it connects! Nice. And that Kerrigan just misused an ult. That's fantastic. Fantastic. Now we're cooking. Yes! Oh, incoming that. We got 29 seconds to get some good business done. Sieging's gonna be a little rough with a Chromie in the mix. But I have Spell Shield available. There's also a moshing ETC that will be waiting. Here he comes. Let's escape through my team. Something I need to work on personally. Okay. We lost all our wells, sadly. I've got 15, but we're sort of splitting off here. Maybe me turning in will keep everyone local. I like that wisp a lot. ETC in the top. Rhaegar in the top. There's Chromie. Right onto poor Li Ming. Oh. Gul'dan is in the bottom at the moment. And Tyrande's working on me. She is slowly getting me topped off. Okay, it's Gul'dan in the bottom. Let's see if we can... Nope, too late. He hasn't been doing a bad job at all. And we've kept a good hold on this lane clear. Yep, no, I've got to come around the side. Oh, dear. Okay, we want to stop Sylvanas from getting the middle. I don't think we can. Two damages down, so let's just not open ourselves up to bonus opportunities. We'll try to get out, but I don't think we are. We have the res. We got a res available, and if we save people who don't res, but no! That was my sweet sacrifice! Looks like we'll get to 20 at about the same time, though. Gul'dan wants orbs, doesn't he? Back on out. Back on out, Li Ming. That is not the angle. And they can see from there. Oh no, I don't have the souls. So, all right. So we got a permanent, well, not a permanent, but a longer death this time. Let's see what we can do. So it's a chaotic energy. Okay, interesting. So she completed the quest. We got nothing really surprising. Prog rock. Essence for essence. Okay. So that's burst damage against me. Seconds. Oh, I think that's a stagger, but Lunara's putting out great damage. She really is. Oh, the two level up burst at us. People like Kerrigan, though. Yeah, and that's just going to be an ult out of her, and that'll be the end. Report Gul'dan. I think that was one of the best Gul'dans I've seen, honestly. He didn't participate as much as I would like, but hey, it was a good Lunara, wasn't it? That's a plus in my book. We walk away with a little bit of experience with a good Lunara on our team. Chromie did a lot of work. She did. Chromie got a lot of value in that game. It was a great late pickup. Gul'dan should have adjusted. Should have had, ideally, like a Zeratul in his book. You know, Gul'dan doesn't have the range to help out with a Chromie. Lunara became our best bet. You know, I mean, I would even love a Sonya or something like that. So, and my team didn't want to play as that's a communication thing I can put on myself. I should have let them know my thoughts coming out of the gate. I just assumed that, you know, we were all on board, that the enemy team clearly had a better, more bursty comp with Kerrigan and Chromie, more ambushy comp, and they would win any engage in the middle there. So I should have taken the time to type out. So play careful. I'm really trying to judge the bossy levels, right? Like how much control can we exert in a solo queue environment? I mean, I exert a lot of control in that first game we did today with Gorath on Tyrael. But I also had him listening to me, and I was able to get the Sylvanas to do what I wanted, and it wasn't a perfect storm either. We had to work a little bit in that game. But I feel like we had a really strong mid-game. All but one of our deaths were resets, and two were sacrifices for other people. Any other tank would have exploded, if not faster. I mean, maybe Johanna survives it, but what does she do to actually, you know, mess with the team comp at all? In the end, it was Withering Fire, so it was a full-on little sand build there. Shifting Sands, but went with the Temporal Loop, even Dragon's Eye on top of that. We got some Blood and Thunder. Kerrigan did go the Essence for Essence. That was for me to deal with my pile of health. I didn't take any health talents. The level 1 health talent anyway, but still, Diablo is a health-based tank. So it got her, oh, interesting, splash damage, huh? And Siphoning Impact, range. And Siphoning Impact there. And it was a, well, actually, a prog rock, but without the healing in an area. I don't think they had a problem healing, though. Was the Tyrande picked up before the Chromie? I don't remember. If so, we really need everyone to be topped off wicked fast, and Tyrande was a bad pick there. If it was picked before the Chromie, then we simply didn't know, and Yerbida wanted to play those mind games, wanted to play chicken with Crydee and get a Gul'dan for himself.